So in previous lecture, we have started unit number 4, numerical integration. In that session, I have elaborated the application of integration, typically definite integral in engineering as well as in the sciences. After that, we came across two types of methods for solving numerical integration. The first one was Newton's Quartus method, and second one was Gauss-Legendre's quadrature method. So these two methods are differentiated or classified based on thickness of the strips. Okay, so both or all our numerical integration methods follows the step something like this. Assume this is some function of x. Okay, and we'd like to calculate area in interval x0 to xn. Means what? We would like to calculate the area under the curve for this particular interval. Okay, so Newton's Quartus method or Gauss-Legendre's quadrature method both works on the same principle of dividing this area into number of strips, number of pieces, or number of segments. Okay, now if the segment thickness is uniform, then the method which we follow is called as the Newton's Quartus method. And if there is a variation between the thicknesses, thickness of a first strip is less than or greater than the thickness of second strip, that means we are implementing Gauss quadrature, Gauss-Legendre's quadrature method. Okay, now previously we have seen one method called as a trapezoidal rule, which belongs to Newton's Quartus method, in which what we do, the function, assume this is your function. If we would like to integrate this function over some interval, we assume that when we provide a strip like this, x0 to x1, these two points are connected with a straight line. Ye apna assumption hai. For second strip, they are connected with the straight line. This is our assumption. Means what? The Newton's interpolating polynomial is of degree 1. Okay, matlab line, linear equation. So, अगर हमने ये assumption किया कि ये जो polynomial है उसका degree 1 है या ये फिर line से join किया है हमने, we are actually implementing trapezoidal rule. Now, the second possibility is joining these two points with the help of parabola. मतलब instead of straight line, we are joining them with the quadratic curve. Third option, we will join them with the cubic curve. Okay, so this follows for Simpson's 1/3 rule and Simpson's 3/8 rule. Now, after learning about the derivation formula for trapezoidal rule, we attempted to solve a numerical based on trapezoidal rule. Okay, now quickly we will go through the or we will have a recap of trapezoidal rule. So a function will be given to you for which we need to integrate this function for interval 0 to 6. So this is your x0 and xn. And this 1 upon 1 plus x squared is function of x or y. Okay? Isko integrate karna hai. Integrate karna hai matlab hum kya karte hai? Yahan pe we call it as approximately this is equal to, integration is equal to area under the curve. Now, the trapezoidal rules. The formula is 1 upon 2h into y0 plus yn plus 2 times y1 plus y2 and so on. Okay, so this formula required h value, y and different y value. How to do that? How to calculate this? So first we need to calculate h. H is nothing but strip thickness. This can be calculated with the help of xn minus x0. upper limit minus lower limit in, of the integration divided by n. n is number of strips. कि भाई वो curve के आप कितने टुकड़े करने वाले हो. Okay. Now n to calculate h, xn is available which is 6, x0 is available which is 0, n I don't know. So assume something. Okay. So if we assume low or smaller number of n, there will be too much approximation, there will be maximum, so there will be lot of error. If we assume large number for n, okay, so 100, 200 number of strips, so we are going for better accuracy, we'll get the better result. Okay, so based on that you will assume n, then you will calculate h. After that we need to calculate y0, yn, y1, y2, etc. So these values are calculated with the help of one table. Okay, so this kind of table, we have seen this table earlier, and in that table we populate data for various values of y based on various values of x. Okay, then we put that data into the giving trapezoidal equation and we calculate area. This area is approximately equal to integration of given function over interval 0 to 6. Okay, so just we have seen the recap of trapezoidal rule. Now we will proceed for Simpson's 1/3 and Simpson's 3/8 rule. If you understand trapezoidal rule, for you Simpson's rules will or seems little easy. Okay, they are just modification of this earlier process. Okay, and also we know that we are not going to go into details of derivation, because derivation will take too much of time and we are learning applied mathematics, so our focus will be on application and fundamentals, not on the derivation part. Okay, so Newton's quotient methods work with the Newton's interpolating formula. Okay, now in trapezoidal rule we assume this polynomial, this interpolating function is of degree 1. Isme jo n di humne 1 dal diya tha and we got the trapezoidal rule ka formula. Now we will change it, we will assume this interpolating polynomial is of order 2. That means we are working on Simpson's 1/3 rule. Okay, now let's see, if the polynomial equation is of order 2, uska general form dekho aap kya rehta hai, f of x. Now this function should be of order 2, so general format is something like this: a0 plus a1x plus a2x square, right? So this is your quadratic curve. Now to find unknowns for this function a0, a1 and a2, there are three unknowns. Remember this, there are three unknowns, and we know that this is kind of a fundamental for us. If we would like to calculate three unknowns, we need at least three equation, then and then hum wo unknown, three unknown calculate kar sakte, right? So coming back to the curve part, your earlier discussion hua abhi 2 minutes earlier, remember this, the bottom line was we should have three equation to find out three unknown. Okay, now next part, coming back to the function, this dark blue line represent actual function of x. Okay, for which we need is f of x ka aapko integration nikalna hai within this limit. Okay, in trapezoidal rule we have connected these two data point with a straight line, but when we go for polynomial of degree 2, that means we are going to connect these two data point with the help of a parabola like this. Now remember, if I assume these two points or this strip is made up of a parabola. That means f of x, this f of x, or I'll write it as a g of x, governing equation for this curve. G of x is of order 2, right? So for that equation, there will be three unknowns. And now currently we are dealing with only two data points, x0 and xn, assume karte. Okay? Now if I write this g of x for x0, g of x0, I'll get one equation. Then I'll use this xn in this equation, g of xn, I'll get second equation. So only two equations I have obtained right now. I cannot solve the equation unknown a0, a1 or a2 with the help of two equations, right? We need at least three equations. So what happens whenever we try to implement the Simpson's one-third rule? We need to have one more data point, one more extra point. Okay. Now again, I'll start from the scratch. This, the blue one, is your function of x, jiska integration nikalna hai. First step, over the limit x0 to xn. So when we need to calculate the area under this curve and we are going for a polynomial of degree 2, what we do? We divide this strip into two parts. Okay, and due to this extra data point, now we fit a curve passing from three data points. Okay, so that means iska meaning kya hai, whenever we say calculating area of one strip, in reality when we implement Simpson's one-third rule, we are actually calculating area of two strips together. Okay, because to solve that equation we need a three data point. Ye dekho, ye ek hua, ye dusra hua, ye teesra hua. So I have three data points, right? So x0 ko dalke g of x0 ek equation banega, g of x1 ek equation banega, g of xn ek equation banega. I'll get three equation, so I will be able to solve those three unknown, right? Okay, so we'll proceed like this. So if we integrate a function with limit x0 to xn for this function of x, approximately it is equal to area under the curve A, and this area is nothing but addition of areas of various strips. जो टुकड़े सेगमेंट्स किए हैं हमने उसका एडिशन है, बट ड्यू टू इंप्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ अ पैराबोला, थोड़ा कॉन्सेंट्रेशन लगाओ यहां पे, ड्यू टू दिस इंप्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ पैराबोला, माय वन स्ट्रिप और वन एरिया शुड बी मेड अप ऑफ थ्री डेटा पॉइंट्स. मतलब हम एक्चुअली क्या कर रहे हैं, दो स्ट्रिप टूगेदर, दोनों का कंबाइन एरिया कैलकुलेट कर रहे हैं. ओके, सो आई विल अज्यूम दैट we need to find out area from x0 to xn, and the strips are like this, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 and n. Okay, so when I calculate area, I am actually calculating this combined area of two strips, right? And I have skipped the derivation for area. Directly I'll show you, if I use parabola to join these three data points together and calculate this area by this by the earlier Newton's interpolating polynomial equation, actually we get this kind of equation, a0 to 2, because we are calculating area from 0 to 2. Ek strip ka nahi, dono strip ka combine dal calculate kar rahe. So that's why I nominated like this, 0 to 2 equal to 1 upon 3 times h, and due to this multiplication factor 1 upon 3, this process, the rule, the method is called as a Simpson's one-third rule. क्योंकि फैक्टर क्या है, 1/3, 1/3 टाइम्स एच इंटू वाई जीरो प्लस 4 टाइम्स वाई वन प्लस वाई टू. ओके, नाउ डोंट आस्क मी द क्वेश्चन ये 4 कैसे आया, बिकॉज टू सॉल्व दिस, टू कम अप विद दिस इक्वेशन एटलीस्ट आई नीड 15 to 20 मिनट्स ऑफ डेरिवेशन. ओके, सो आई हैव टोल्ड यू अर्लियर वी आर गोना स्किप द डेरिवेशन पार्ट. डायरेक्टली रिमेंबर द इक्वेशन इज समथिंग लाइक दिस, 1/3 h y0 प्लस 4 टाइम्स y1 प्लस y2. इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर फॉर ट्रेपेजॉइडल रूल आई हैव एक्सप्लेन हाउ दैट 1/2 टाइम्स h y0 प्लस y1 अपीयर. इसका मैंने डेरिवेशन लिया है, तो सिम्पसन्स का मैं नहीं जाऊंगा. ओके, सो नाउ इफ यू ऑब्जर्व द एरिया फॉर फर्स्ट टू स्ट्रिप्स अपीयर लाइक दिस. सिमिलरली if I go for the next area, that means I am calculating area 2, but this area 2 is nothing but combination of this strip and the strip. So 2 to 3 or 3 to 4 in dono ko combination hai. So next area, area 2 to 4 is equal to 1/3 h y2 plus 4 y3 plus y4. ओके, ये जो है वो मिडल वाला पोर्शन रहता है. सो यू विल फॉलो लाइक दिस, यू विल कैलकुलेट एरिया फॉर दिस मेनी पार्ट. सो दिस इज जनरल इक्वेशन फॉर एरिया फॉर एवरी स्ट्रिप और एवरी सेगमेंट. नाउ हियर यू नीड टू रिमेंबर ओनली टू थिंग्स. फर्स्ट थिंग इज काइंड ऑफ अ नोट हियर, इफ you would like to divide the curve and implement Simpson's 1/3 rule, what could be a kind of a condition here? The number of strips should be in multiples of 2 only. Reason, क्योंकि क्या होता है, जब आप एरिया कैलकुलेट करते हो, आप एरिया कैलकुलेट करते हो कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ टू स्ट्रिप. जस्ट इमेजिन अगर यहां पे एक ही स्ट्रिप होता, कैन यू इंप्लीमेंट द सिम्पसन्स 1/3 रूल? नो, बिकॉज फॉर वन स्ट्रिप आई कैन नॉट हैव दैट इंटरपोलेटिंग फॉर्मूला और पैराबोला. ओके, बिकॉज इट हैज ओनली टू डेटा पॉइंट, वी कैन नॉट इंप्लीमेंट दैट. सो there is a condition, we should always have number of segments in multiples of 2 to implement Simpson's 1/3 rule. So remember this. So this is your one learning. Second learning, if you look at this, the total area or total integration will be combination, addition of all these terms. Okay, all these terms inka add karna hai. So second thing you will observe here, y0 and yn are appearing only single time, but y2 two times aa raha hai, y4 two times aa raha hai, similarly y6 also will appear two times. So y2 4 6 are going to appear two times when I sum up all the equation. Third thing you will observe, y1 y3 y5 and so on, this 1 3 5 7 9, these will have multiplication of 4 with them. Okay, so y terms of 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 will be having multiplication factor 4. 2, 4, 6, 8 will have multiplication factor 2. And y0 and yn will have multiplication factor 1 only. Okay, so based on this, we develop an equation for your Simpson's 1/3 rule. See, inko sab add kar diya humne. What will get? An equation like this. 1/3 h into y0 plus yn, because they appeared only single time in the complete summation, Then y1, y3, y5, y7, etc. That means y with odd terms are having multiplication factor 4. Then plus 2 into y2 plus y4 plus y6 plus y8 and so on. So that means y even term. So जब even term होगी y even terms जो होगा उसको multiply करना है 2 से, अगर odd terms होगा उसको multiply करना है 4 से, y0 और yn को multiply करना है 1 से and do the summation. You will get the integration or area under the curve. Okay. So please all of you note down this formula, because when you try to solve a numerical you require the formula and one condition. Condition is n should be multiples of 2 or they should be even. To implement Simpson's 1/3 rule, num n should be 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, like this. They should be in multiples of 2 or they should be in even number. So make a note of this formula and condition n should be even. So are there any doubt regarding Simpson's 1/3 rule? In the latter stage, we are going to solve a numerical based on this. Okay, so if there are no doubt, we'll proceed ahead. We'll go for Simpson's 3/8 rule. And 3/8 rule is also just kind of a modification of trapezoidal or Simpson's 1/3 rule. So in Simpson's 3/8 rule, we assume this Newton's interpolating polynomial equation is of order or degree 3. It's a cubic equation. Now cubic equation, general formula is something like this: a0 plus a1x plus a2x square plus a3x cube. Right? So this is your cubic equation. Now how many unknowns are there, coefficients? A0, A1, A2, A3. So 4 unknowns are there. And we know that if we would like to calculate 4 unknowns, we should have 4 equations. And to have 4 equations, we should have 4 data points or points on the curve. So similarly, what we have learned in the Simpson's 1/3. 1/3 में क्या होता था, दो सॉरी 3 डेटा पॉइंट्स को मिला के आपकी एक स्ट्रिप बन जाती थी, और इट इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ 2 स्ट्रिप्स, इट बिकम्स 1 एरिया. राइट? इन सिम्पसन्स 3/8 रूल, एज देयर आर 4 अननोन्स, वी नीड 4 डेटा पॉइंट्स. सो when I calculate area, I am actually calculating area for 3 strips together, because they cover 4 data points, 1, 2 and 3. Okay. So this blue one is your actual curve, and this red one which I have drawn or dotted one is assumption or assumption ki bhai aapka curve actually ye hoga, and this portion is error. Okay, so we have discussed the 1/3 rule in a detail, so that's why we are not going to spend too much of time on the 3/8 rule. But remember, yahan pe kya hota hai, 3 strips mila ke ek area banta hai aapka. Okay, ya fir remember 3 strips together or 4 data points together. So from this, can you make one note? Like, if we would like to implement 1/3 rule, number of strips should be even, right? So if you would like to implement Simpson's 3/8 rule, number of strips should be what? In the chat window, you can write your comment. So one option is they should be odd. So one answer we obtained is odd. So Pratik, you are correct. They should be in multiples of 3. They should be in multiples of 3. For example, okay, so like example leta hu, ye aisa curve hai, theek hai, aur odd number choose karte 5, so ek one strip ho gaya, two strip, second strip, third strip, fourth strip, and this is fifth strip, okay, and we will try to implement Simpson's 3/8 rule. 3/8 rule, that means we need to combine 4 data points together to get one area. Okay, so data point number 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, so we'll assume that isme se jaane wala aisa kuch to bhi curve hai apna. Now for the next strip, so this become one area, 3 strip together one area. Now, so if we would like to have one more curve, cubic curve, it should have 4 data points. But see, yahan pe 1, 2, and 3. There are only 3 data points, and we cannot draw a cubic curve with only 3 data points. The reason is there are 4 unknowns. What we can do with the 3 equations, right? So, ye do strip hoke bhi fayda nahi hai. Yahan pe aur ek chahiye hame. So either we can work with 3 strips or 6 strips or 9 strips or 12 strips or 15 strips. That means the number of segments should be in multiples of 3. So I guess all of you have understood this part. Now quickly we'll go through the formulation. So again, we are going to skip the derivation of this formula. Ultimately, if we solve this 3 strips together, so that's why it starts with 0 and jump on to the 3. So 0 to 1 to 2 to 3. We combine all these 3 strips together and get only one area. And that area is calculated with this formula, 3/8 × h. Now due to this multiplication factor 3/8, you understood why the Simpson's 3/8 rule it is called. Okay, so 3/8 × h into y0 plus 3 × y1 plus 3 × y2 plus y3. Okay, next you will go for 3 to 6, right? तो 3 to 6 के लिए ये फॉर्मूला बनेगा y3 प्लस 3 × y4 प्लस 3 × y5 प्लस 3 × y6 एंड सो ऑन. ओके, देन टू कैलकुलेट टोटल एरिया वी नीड टू ऐड दिस ऑल फॉर फॉर्मूले और फॉर ऑल टर्म्स टुगेदर. व्हाट वी विल गेट इज इक्वेशन समथिंग लाइक दिस. नाउ हियर व्हाट वी विल डू, 3/8 h, we will take it out. Next, y0 and yn, they are appearing single time only. So y0 plus yn, start wala or end wala y, plus. Now see, 3 × y1 plus 3 × y2 plus 3 × y4 plus 3 × y5 and so on. So 3 × y1 plus y2, skip the y3, then y4 plus y5. Skip the y6, then y7 and y8 and so on. Plus this y3, and here there is one more y3. So y3 plus y3, 2y3, right? Also y6, and there here it will be also y6. So plus y6 plus y9 and so on. Okay, so aapka equation something like, it will become something like this. So you can observe here, except y with multiples of 3 will not be here, and here in the second bracket there will be y's with multiples of 3. So 3, 6, 9, they will appear here. So finally, your equation for calculating area using Simpson's 3-8 rule is like this. Please make a note of this equation. This is required. And a condition. Condition kya hona chahiye? N should be in multiples of 3. So n should be 3, 6, 9, 12, so on. So write down these two things, condition and formula for Simpson's 3-8 rule. If you remember this formula, you will be able to calculate numerical integration. Okay, so I'll assume that you have noted down this formula, or take the screenshot of this slide. Now next we will solve one numerical on Simpson's 1/3 rule. Now the next numerical is a little bit different than the earlier numerical. A different kind of or class of numerical we will observe. Read the problem statement. The velocity v, which is specified in kilometers per minute, of a moped which start from a rest is given at a fixed interval of time t as follow. So there is a table. So it starts from rest, then at time t the velocity was 10, at time 4 the velocity was 18, and so on. It is populated, or it is present in the data, and we have been asked to approximately calculate the distance covered in 20 minutes. Okay, now just imagine this kind of problem you come across. How to solve this numerical? First thing, we need to observe ki bhai ye aap numerical integration se kaise ye related hai. Why this kind of statement appears for, or it come follows under numerical integration? We know that rate of change of displacement is a velocity. Okay, it has been asked us to calculate distance, matlab displacement nikalna hai. And the velocity is given. Also the governing or the independent parameter t is given. So we know that ds by dt is equal to v, rate of change of displacement is equal to velocity. We will manipulate this equation, take the dt onto the right hand side, we get ds change in displacement is equal to velocity times dt. Okay, now if I integrate this over the interval 0 to 20, sorry, 0 to 20, What I'll get? S. Distance covered from 0 time up to 20, or 0 from start to 20 minutes, which is equal to integration 0 to 20 for velocity dt. Okay. And now, due to this equation, we can implement a numerical method of integration to get to our answer. Okay, so let's do that. So that means we need to solve integration. We are going to implement numerical integration here. Now, numerical integration karna hai matlab aapko kya karna padega? You need to implement some kind of formula. So you have option trapezoidal rule, Simpson's 1/3 rule and Simpson's 3/8 rule. Kaun sa use karenge? So first we'll try to implement 3/8 rule. Okay. But can we implement this 3/8 rule to this equation, this observed data? Just count how many strips are there. So remember, थोड़ा confusing आपको, थोड़ा गड़बड़ करने के लिए उन्होंने डेटा थोड़ा गलत नहीं, confusing दिया है. See, there is one data missing. Remember the moped which starts from rest. उन्होंने क्लियरली बताया कि वे स्टार्ट फ्रॉम रेस्ट, राइट? एंड ऑल्सो वी नो दैट वी नीड टू इंटीग्रेट, वी नीड टू कैलकुलेट डिस्टेंस आफ्टर 20 मिनट्स. दैट मीन्स फ्रॉम जीरो अप टू 20 मिनट्स. सो जीरो टू 20 मिनट्स का डिस्टेंस कवर करना है, उतना वेलोसिटी आपको एड करना है, समअप करना है. सो द वन डेटा दे हैवंट गिवन इज व्हेन टी इज इक्वल टू जीरो, velocity is equal to zero. Now how many data points we have here? We denote it by I. Okay, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Okay, so we have 11 data point, which means how many strips? Which means 10 strips. So with the help of 11 data points, we have 10 strips. And to implement a 3/8 rule, number of strips should be 3, 6, 9, 12. It should be in multiples of 3. So we cannot implement 3/8 rule. So next option, we have 1/3 rule and trapezoidal rule. Okay, so Simpson's 1/3 or trapezoidal rule. And it has been observed that the Simpson's 1/3 rule is having a little better accuracy compared to trapezoidal rule. Okay, so that's why we will go for Simpson's 1/3 rule, because we can implement Simpson's 1/3 rule for n equal to 10. 10 is in multiples of 2, or it's an even number. So definitely we can implement Simpson's 1/3 rule for solving this numerical. Okay, so we'll solve this numerical. First we need to calculate h. So h ka formula apne paas hai, xn minus x0 divided by n. Xn upper limit of the integration, which is 20. X0 is the lower limit of the integration, which is 0. N number of strips. So from this count, from the data, number of strips observed are 10. So h is equal to 2. Or directly, if you look at the data, the difference step size for t is how much? 2 only. So 8 to 10, kitna difference hai? 2 ka difference. So h strip thickness become 2. Now next task is the formula for calculating Simpson's, calculating area using Simpson's 1/3 rule. So h we observe it's 2, y0. Now humne kya kiya tha earlier, table wagera banaya tha, but already yahan pe problem statement itself has that table, so no worries, bahut kaam aasan hua aapka. y0, ab y0 kya hai? F of x0 or f of t0 rest ke time. So y0 is 0, बहुत बार यहां पे बच्चे मिस्टेक कर देते, दे एज्यूम वाई जीरो टू बी 10. रिमेंबर इट स्टार्ट विथ जीरो, तो जीरो ये वन है, 10 इज एट वाई वन, सो वाई जीरो इक्वल टू जीरो, वाई एन इज ऑल्सो जीरो, देन प्लस फोर टाइम्स वाई वन, सो वाई वन इज 10, प्लस वाई थ्री 25, प्लस 32, प्लस 11, प्लस 2, ओके, सो यू गॉट दिस ऑड टर्म्स, प्लस 2 टाइम्स वाई इवन टर्म, इवन टर्म में आता है आपका 18, प्लस 29, प्लस दिस 20, प्लस 5, ओके, जस्ट आप उसके बाद क्या है, जस्ट कैलकुलेशन करना है आपको, नो इश्यू, सो डू दैट कैलकुलेशन, यू विल गेट एरिया इक्वल टू 309.33, एंड हियर द एरिया इज नथिंग बट द डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल बाय मोपेड इन 20 मिनट्स, विच इज इक्वल टू 309.333 किलोमीटर्स, ओके, सो एनी डाउट हियर? If not, take a screenshot for your reference. Okay, so let's proceed now. We'll solve one numerical on Simpson's 3A tool. So that will be our next numerical. इट बिलोंग्स टू द फर्स्ट क्लास, आपने जो पहला क्लास ऑफ न्यूमेरिकल देखा था उस रिलेटेड है, ओके, नाउ हियर वी नीड टू इंटीग्रेट दिस फंक्शन साइन ऑफ एक्स माइनस लॉग ऑफ एक्स प्लस ई रेज टू एक्स विथ इंटरवल 0.2 to 1.4, ओके, एंड नो नीड टू थिंक ऑन विच मेथड टू इम्प्लीमेंट, डिरेक्टली द प्रॉब्लम स्टेटमेंट इटसेल्फ सजेस्ट अस टू यूज सिम्पसन्स 3A टूल. Okay, so we are going to implement Simpson's 3A tool. So first thing we need to decide or assume how many pieces or how many segments you are going to create for this function. So ये आपका जो curve होगा sin of x minus log of x plus e raised to x, तो इसके कितने segments बनाने हैं? Okay, so this x varies from 0.2 up to 1.4. यहां तक जाना है आपको. Okay, so how many segments we should prepare? We know that we are going to implement Simpson's 3A rule. So n should be in multiples of 3. It should be in multiples of 3. So you have option. You can have n equal to 3 or 6 or 9 or 12 or 15 and so on. Okay, now based on your requirement, do you want to have a better accuracy? Okay, then you have to go for a larger number. Agar aapko quickly solve karna hai, kitna bhi error hone do, no issue. Go for less number of strips. Okay, so what we will do here, when we write a program for this method, we will go for 120 strips or 150 strips. बिकॉज ये हमें कैलकुलेशन नहीं करने, वो प्रोग्राम को करने, सॉफ्टवेयर को करना है, बट एज एज ह्यूमन बीइंग वी हैव अ लिमिटेशन, वी विल चूज अ लेसर नंबर, सो आइदर वी कैन गो फॉर 6, 9 or 12, थ्री इज टू स्मॉल नंबर, ओके, सो डो अवॉइड यूजिंग थ्री नंबर, गो फॉर 6, 9 or 12 नंबर ऑफ स्ट्रिप्स. सो हियर व्हाट आई विल डू, आई माय सेल्फ विल ट्राई टू यूज 12 नंबर ऑफ स्ट्रिप्स, okay, so to get a better accuracy, so n equal to 12 assume karta hu. Now based on that we will calculate h, so xn is 1.4, x0 is 0.2, and n we have assumed 12, okay, so this is our assumption, h we got is equal to 0.1. now next we will call that formula. Let's see what are the things we need to find more. So 3 by 8 H. चलो यहां तक का पार्ट हमने टैकल कर लिया. देन नेक्स्ट पार्ट इज Y0 एंड YN, देन Y1 2 3 वगैरह वगैरह अप टू Y12 सब निकलना है हमें. ओके, सो Y0 टू Y12 कैलकुलेट करना है. हाउ टू डू दैट कैलकुलेशन आई विल एलैबोरेट. एक्चुअली आई हैव टोल्ड यू अर्लियर इन द प्रीवियस यस्टरडेज थ्योरी लेक्चर. वी डू दैट कैलकुलेशन विद द हेल्प ऑफ वन टेबल. ओके, सो दोज हु आर एब्सेंट और हु डिडंट रिकॉल और कुडंट रिकॉल, फॉर देम आई विल शो यू. हियर वी नीड टू मेक प्रिपेयर प्रिपेयर थ्री कॉलम्स. फर्स्ट वन इज फॉर आई, नेक्स्ट वन इज एक्स एंड लास्ट वन इज वाई. ओके, नाउ आई इज काइंड ऑफ अ सीरियल नंबर बट नॉट सीरियल नंबर बिकॉज इट स्टार्ट विथ जीरो. रीजन, आपको यहाँ पे वाई जीरो चाहिए, राइट? सो जीरो से स्टार्ट करो, देन गो फॉर वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव अप टू ट्वेल्व. ओके, सो जीरो टू ट्वेल्व. नेक्स्ट यू नीड टू कैलकुलेट एक्स. सो एक्स जीरो कितना है? एक्स जीरो इज पॉइंट टू, वी नो दिस. एक्स जीरो इज पॉइंट टू. एंड एक्स एन वी नो, एक्स ट्वेल्व एक्स एन इज नथिंग बट 1.4. नेक्स्ट थिंग वी नो इज एच. एच कितना है? 0.1. सो लास्ट टाइम आई हैव गिवन यू अ फॉर्मूला, एक्स जीरो प्लस आई टाइम्स एच, इसका यूज करो और सिंपली जस्ट एड एच इन द प्रीवियस एक्स. सो यू गेट एक्स वन इक्वल टू 0.3, देन 0.4, 0.5, 0.6 एंड सो ऑन. ठीक है, और यू कैन इंप्लीमेंट दिस फॉर्मुलेशन. दिस इज जनरल इक्वेशन विच यू आर गोइंग टू यूज इन द प्रोग्रामिंग पार्ट. एक्स जीरो प्लस आई टाइम्स एच, दोनों से एक ही आंसर आता है. ओके, देन द लास्ट कॉलम विच इज द डिजायर्ड कॉलम ऑफ वाई. वाई जीरो पहले कैलकुलेट करते हैं. वाई जीरो इज नथिंग बट एफ ऑफ एक्स जीरो. ओके, एक्स जीरो को फंक्शन में डालो. फंक्शन क्या है? साइन ऑफ एक्स माइनस लॉग ऑफ एक्स प्लस ई रेस टू एक्स. सो यू विल ओपन योर कैलकुलेटर. कैलकुलेटर में फॉर्मूला फिट कर दोगे इसका. फॉर वेरियस वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स यू विल कैलकुलेट करस्पॉन्डिंग वाई यूजिंग दैट कैलकुलेटर एंड यू विल राइट द डेटा इन टेबल वाई वन वाई टू एटसेट्रा अप टू वाई ट्वेल्व. यूजिंग दिस टेबल इसका सब डेटा इधर डाल दोगे आप एंड यू विल गेट योर आंसर ऑफ एरिया. सो आई हैव प्रिपेयर्ड अ टेबल लाइक दिस. ओके, now we are going to put the data into the equation. So y0 and yn, next I need 3 times y1 y2 plus y4 plus y5 and so on. So maine thoda with the different ink I have shown. So inka summation kar lo and put it in the equation. It appears to be 26.9075. next I need 2 times y multiples of 3, so y3 plus y6 and so on. So let's do that. Okay, so this 2.82 plus 3.16 plus 3.8001, it comes as 9.7874. okay, उसके बाद सबका एडिशन कर दिया. दिस इक्वेशन वी कैन सॉल्व एंड यू विल गेट द एरिया, फाइनल एरिया. सो आंसर कम्स एज 4.0511 एंड दिस इज योर फाइनल आंसर. सो टेक अ स्क्रीनशॉट ऑफ दिस स्लाइड फॉर योर रेफरेंस हाउ टू अटेम्प्ट दिस क्वेश्चन. Now for today's attendance, please try to solve this numerical. It's simple one. आपको एक ही table दिया है, so table is already prepared for you guys. Number of strips are also given or h is directly given, which is equal to 0.2. You have y0, yn, y1, y2, all the data present in the table. Okay. You need to implement a trapezoidal rule, Simpson's 1/3 rule and Simpson's 3/8 rule. मतलब ये तीन फॉर्मूले भी मैंने आपके लिए रेफरेंस के लिए डाल दी इधर. जस्ट पुट द डेटा, डू द कैलकुलेशन एंड गेट द एरिया यूजिंग दीज थ्री मेथड, ट्रेपेजॉइडल रूल, सिम्पसन्स 1/3 रूल एंड सिम्पसन्स 3/8 रूल. ओके, ट्राई टू डू दैट, ट्राई टू सॉल्व दिस न्यूमेरिकल. एंटर योर रोल नंबर और टूडेज अटेंडेंस अलॉन्ग विद द एंसर फॉर दीज थ्री मेथड into the Google form. मैं चैट विंडो में आपके लिंक भेज देता हूँ गूगल फॉर्म का, प्लीज यूज दैट. नाउ फॉर दिस डेटा यू कैन इम्प्लीमेंट ट्रेपेजॉइडल रूल बिकॉज देर इज नो कंस्ट्रेंट ऑन नंबर ऑफ सेगमेंट्स फॉर ट्रेपेजॉइडल रूल. ऑल्सो यू कैन इम्प्लीमेंट सिम्पसन्स 1/3 रूल हियर बिकॉज नंबर ऑफ स्ट्रिप्स आर हाउ मेनी, 6. सो दिस इज 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 7 data points means 6 number of strips. So it's a even number. You can implement Simpson's 1/3 rule. 6 is nothing but a multiple of 3 also. So you can implement Simpson's 3/8 rule. So try this. You will find there will be little difference between answer obtained by all these three methods. Okay, so try. If somebody has doubt, they can raise their query.